I want to show you 3 tips that will help you write better Swift code. Let's start with tip number 1. When we need a string to display over several lines, the standard approach is to add line breaks using the special character \n. While this works perfectly, it has the drawback of seriously degrading the readability of the code. That's when a nice feature of Swift called multi-line strings comes in handy. By using 3 double quotes instead of 1, we turn our string into a multi-line string. Now we no longer need to use the special character \n, we can just simply use regular line breaks and Swift will take them into account. Let's move on to the second tip. You've probably already encountered the situation where you define a generic argument that is used only a single time in the signature of the method. While this kind of code is perfectly valid, since Swift 5.7, there's actually a shorter syntax for it. Instead of explicitly defining a generic argument, you can use the keyword sum to use an opaque argument. This new syntax is conceptually equivalent to the previous one. The only difference is that the generic argument has now become anonymous, meaning we can't refer to it afterwards. But since we weren't doing it in the first place, it's no problem here. Moving on to the last tip. Consider this code. We are writing a test, and inside that test, we need to call a function that can throw. If you expect your test to fail when that function throws, then your first intuition might be to use try! When calling that function. While this works, it comes with a significant drawback. When the function does throw, it will actually crash your entire test process. That's probably not what you want. You would more probably want the test to fail and have subsequent tests keep executing. As it turns out, this is quite easy to achieve. We just mark our test with the keyword froze, and thanks to this small change, the test will now automatically fail when any unhandled error is thrown inside of it. That's it. These were the 3 tips I wanted to share with you. I hope you enjoyed them and they will indeed help you write better Swift code. If you want to see more tips like these, I've got quite a few of them on my website. The link is in the description. Thank you for watching and see you next time.